Step 10. Depositing clones in a library. Creating a clone library is important for just one reason, so that you can find your clones when you need them. Maybe your colleague wants to continue your project, or you publish your results, and somebody requests a clone. In times like that, it is very satisfying to know where your clones are. I keep the information about my clone library in the Excel spreadsheet. I assign each of my clones a number, which is stored in the Excel file along with the clone name, description, the name of the parental vector, date created, primer names, and whatever other information I find relevant. For each clone, I prepare two 2 milliliter screw cap tubes with clone name and number. In one of the tubes, I am going to put the DNA, all 100 microliters that I looted from the mini prep. And in the second tube, I will store the E.coli culture, the one that we saved earlier today, right before starting the mini prep protocol. In this case, I will use 900 microliters of E.coli culture. And in addition, I will put 100 microliters of dimethyl sulfoxide, or DMSO, which will serve as cryoprotectant for the E.coli cells. Here is the original DMSO bottle, and here is an aliquot that I use on an everyday basis. I will mix the E.coli culture with DMSO by flipping the tube over a couple of times. I will put the 2 milliliter library tubes into two boxes that I prepared here, a -80 box for the E.coli and -20 degree box for DNA. The DNA box goes into -20 degree freezer, and the E.coli culture box goes into -80 degree freezer.